Dr. Swaroop Rawal conducts educational camps across the country where she teaches students various subjects through drama. In the summer of 2012, she began her 10-day camp at the LP Savani Academy in Surat to teach 40 students from the ages of 8 to 14 the Dandi March and civil disobedience through drama and take Gandhiji out of the textbook.
What exactly is teaching through drama?
Teaching through drama is very simple. It's about using drama to bring about a change in understanding. Drama in education is about the teacher and the student. It is not about making a play, but the process of making a play. The change of understanding or learning happens in the process. Of course, there would be a play all through, but the learning is in the process and not the final product. There are different methods used in it. One of them is theatre games, then there is tableaus, improvisations. The whole class works in one single play, and it may be 20 people, 30 people, and the whole play may go on for 3, 4, 5 consecutive lessons. So it just depends on the teacher, how she wants to use it.
Everything is done through drama. So they've been doing drama. It's not, because I don't believe in making actors, it's not about making actors. This is called drama in education. So it is how drama is used to teach.
On the 12th of March, 1930, Mahatma Gandhi marched to Dandi to break the unjust tax on salt applied by the British Empire. This legendary march was a cornerstone in the history of our nation. Yet today, despite having studied it over and over again in their textbooks, many students don't remember a thing about it.
Non-cooperation movement.
What is that?
So, what did you learn about Bharat's freedom? What did you learn? आपको दांडी मार्च के बारे में क्या पता?
दांडी मार्च
ठीक है, तो कैसे किया था उन्होंने दांडी मार्च? तो सत्याग्रह विषय तुमने सुना होगा।
सत्याग्रह के संस्कृत में कंट्री।
और आपने गांधी जी और हमारे इंडिपेंडेंस मूवमेंट का आपने कौन से स्टैंडर्ड से पढ़ना चालू किया?
मेरे हिसाब से मैंने थर्ड फोर्थ में किया।
थर्ड फोर्थ से आपने चालू किया पढ़ना इंडियन मूवमेंट के बारे में। अच्छा, थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू।
हाउ इज टीचिंग थ्रू ड्रामा डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द रेगुलर वे ऑफ टीचिंग?
द मेन डिफरेंस इज दैट इट्स एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग. You experience everything, the characters, the people, the things experienced at the time when it happened to them, instead of just opening a textbook and listening and reading words.
Generally what happens today, if you find 90% page, 95% A++ grade, A grade, and thought computation, what we say, like they learn. But at times we find that the learning is a bit hollow because of surface level.
Yes.
Textbook learning can never empower the kids because they're just learning it by heart. And like I keep telling them that they are taking it in and vomiting it out in the exams. And it's really as gross as that.
Students, they must understand the depth of the content. It is not necessary they should know everything, but whatever they know, it should be acquired well. They should be able to construct, acquire knowledge in a better way.
So here the students go through the whole process that the characters probably went through or something similar. So there is a great, huge amount of empathy. So when your skills of empathy are improved, you become a better learner.
જ્યારે શીખવાડતી હોઉં છું ત્યારે હું પહેલી મેથડથી શીખવાડતી
When I teach with a textbook, once I tell them the story, I do not immediately know whether they have understood anything until I take a test. Whereas here they are supposed to make a play immediately after. So if they are confused, they come up and ask me questions. So as a teacher, I can see how much they have understood and clear up their doubts if any arise. That I think is an advantage of this method.
એ મને સારો એવો એડવાન્ટેજ લાગે છે આ મેથડ.
કેન બેટર ટેકનોલોજી ઓર ફેસિલિટીઝ ઇમ્પ્રુવ ધ ઇફેક્ટિવનેસ ઓફ ધીસ મેથડ?
નો, આઈ ડોન્ટ થિંક સો. આઈ ડોન્ટ થિંક ઇટ કેન રીલી ઇમ્પ્રુવ ઇટ. આઈ થિંક ટેકનોલોજી વુડ જસ્ટ ઇમ્પ્રુવ ધ ફ્રિલ્સ. લાઈક ઇફ આઈ હેડ અ બેટર પ્રિન્ટર, આઈ વુડ હેવ ગોટ બેટર પ્રિન્ટ આઉટ્સ ડન, યુ નો, ઓન અ કમ્પ્યુટર. વોટ આઈ રીલી નીડ ઇઝ અ નાઇસ વાઇડ ઓપન હોલ એન્ડ અ હોલ લોટ ઓફ ચિલ્ડ્રન હુ આર રેડી ટુ લર્ન.
How did you teach the children the Dandi March?
So I chose the subject and I decided to introduce it to them in a very different way. When some teachers saw my notes, they thought this was really difficult to teach. And they would be really surprised to know that actually it is not difficult if you can present it in a proper way. So I introduced them to a play that was written 2 millennia back called Antigone. And that is the first civil disobedience that we know of.
The story of Antigone is based on the fighting for your rights, for your values. It was a non-violent act, an act of civil disobedience. The two princes killed each other at war. The king's favorite prince gave an upward burial, and the other prince was left to rot outside the city walls. His sister breaks the law and gives her brother burial at the cost of her life.
Then I got them to a time closer to our times, when I took them to Alabama, to the Montgomery bus incident, where Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. fought for the black rights. When I did the whole incident of the line lesson, they understood that we're all same. And so they learned that there should not be a difference between the black and white. And this is something we Indians understand too, because we have a lot of caste problems. Everybody will get one. And you have to see your limbu properly and be able to identify it.
All of them have individually marked the lemon.
Necessarily mean just drama. There are various things you can use. Like I had the exhibition of the photographs. I read out the speech which Gandhiji said. And then when they saw a picture of 10,000 plus people standing on the banks of Sabarmati, and then they imagined Gandhiji saying the words I said. I They could really understand what it meant. And they were very moved by it.
We are going to take an interview of Gandhiji. This interview is happening on the 11th of March 1930. Before the beginning of the salt satyagraha.
I am from Gujarat Samachar and my question is, મીઠા પરત કેમ સત્યાગ્રહ કર્યો? જો હવા અને પાણી પછી મીઠો સૌથી મહત્વપૂર્ણ ચીજ છે. એ ગરીબ અમીર અને પશુઓને બધાને જોઈએ છે અને એ જ બ્રિટિશ સરકારે એની ઉપર ટેક્સ લગાવી દીધો. હું તો એમને કહું છું એ દારૂ પર, વિદેશી કપડા ઉપર યા ઘી પર ટેક્સ લગાવે, પણ એમને નમક પર ટેક્સ લગાવ્યો એટલા માટે હું એના વિરોધ કરું છું.
Now this works in two ways. One is that the person is free to say what he wants and what he knows and what he understands. But for a teacher, it can be a test to see how much the children have actually grasped of what she was teaching. And then, of course, the field trip to Dandi, and where we met the freedom fighter. And we actually saw the hut in which Gandhiji lived in. Actually seeing it after doing the drama, after doing it all, gives it so much more meaning.
તમે બધાને ખૂબ એવું હતું ને કે આપણે ફ્રીડમ ફાઈટર્સને મળીએ, સ્વાતંત્ર્ય સેનાનીને મળીએ. પહેલાના જમાનામાં ગાંધીજી હતા ત્યારે શું થતું હતું, કેવી રીતે એ લોકોએ આઝાદી મેળવી, એ તો બધું બહુ ટફ હતું ને. જો અહીંયા જે દાદા બેઠા છે ને, એમનું નામ છે ગોસાઈ દાદા અને એમની ઉંમર છે 92 વર્ષ, 92 યર્સ, બરાબર. અને એ જ્યારે તમારા જેવડા હતા ને ત્યારે ગાંધીજી અહીંયા આવેલા.
એ જ્યાં તમે રસ્તે આવ્યા ત્યાં એક પાચા કાકા વાળી નામની જગ્યા જોઈ હશે, ત્યાં આગળ એક વડ છે. એટલે હવે ગાંધીજી આવવાના એ તો મને ખબર, કારણ કે તો અગાઉથી જ એની બધી તૈયારીઓ ચાલતી હોય કે આજે આવવાના, કાલે આવવાના. એટલે વડની ઓછી ભરાઈને હું કૂચ આવતી જોતો હતો. એટલે કૂચ એટલે શું, જાણે કે એક લશ્કર આવતું હોય એમ દસ્તું, એવી રીતે ગાંધીજી લાકડી સાથે આગળ ચાલે ને એની હાથ બધા એના સાથીઓ ચાલે.
માર્ગમાં કંઠે પડ્યા સૌને નડ્યા, બાજુ મૂક્યા ઊંચકી, ત્યાંથી ઊંચકીને તમે બાજુ મૂક્યા. તેથી નક્કી જન્મ ગાંધી બાપુનો, તિથિ ન જોશો ટીપણે ગાંધી જયંતિ તે દિને.
So what did you all do in the show?
Well, we performed the play, but the show is not the most important part of this drama camp. In the sense is that all the learning has already happened in the 9 days before the show, which is performed on the 10th day. So basically, the show is a sweet way when we can share with the parents the learning and the experiences the children had in the 9 days.
जो भी बच्चे यहाँ आपके सामने कर रहे हैं वो उन्होंने खुद किया है सीखने के बाद. जो भी छोटे से नाटक होंगे, कुछ स्टैच्यूज जैसा प्रोग्राम होगा, वो सब उन्होंने ही लिखा है, उनकी भाषा में लिखा है. शायद कभी कच्चा लगे, कभी पक्का लगे, पता नहीं, क्योंकि उन्होंने, मैंने कुछ दिखाया नहीं उनको, मैंने सिर्फ उनको सिविल डिसोबीडियंस सिखाया, डांडी मार्च सिखाया, अमेरिका में सिविल मूवमेंट, सिविल डिसोबीडियंस हुआ था वो सिखाया, ये सब चीज़ें सिखाई. और उन्होंने ये पूरा प्रेजेंटेशन अपने आप आपके लिए रेडी किया है, इसलिए मैं तो बैक स्टेज में भी नहीं बैठने वाली हूँ, मैं भी ऑडियंस में बैठने वाली हूँ आपके साथ.
इन द शो we had the different tableaus, We had the small little skits which they did, the improvisations, the Gandhi interview. And in this play, I give everybody a chance to come on stage.
It's not their performance that matters in the little improvisations, is it?
No, the performance really doesn't matter. But there's a catch in this. Is that you have to follow the rule of the medium. In the senses, when you're writing a composition, you need to be able to use good words and good sentences, and you need to be grammatically correct. If you're painting, you need to be able to use paint. If you're singing, you need to be able to sing well. The same thing is in drama, you need a certain amount of creativity. You need a certain amount of performance. You need to be true to the laws of the medium.
Describe a typical day in your drama camp.
The drama camp day begins at 6 o'clock when the bell rings, and around 6:15 we start yoga. The drama class is divided into two parts of the day. One is from 9 to 12 and the other is from 2:30 to about 4:35. In both of them, I do something different. First, in any case, I always begin with the warm-ups and we play some typical icebreaker game which the kids like, and you know, to get them all into the mood. The main part of the drama I do it in that time. In the afternoon, because our afternoons are quite hot and oppressive, I tell them stories and then I ask them to, you know, enact them, and you know, I do all that type of work in the second half. So I've divided it when I do the main work in the morning, where we make the plays which we learnt the story of in the previous class and all that. You know, the things which they really have to do a lot of thinking and work. After 12, then it's lunch. After lunch, they're free to do whatever they want till 2:30, and that means they have to wash their clothes, have a bath, whoever has not had a bath, and if somebody wants to catch up and have a little nap, which they rarely did, but yeah, they can do that. Again, the drama camp, the drama class starts from 2:30 to 4:30 or 5, usually about 4:30, quarter to 5, and then there's tea time, and we have tea and a snack. And after tea, we have the organized games, which are outdoor games. And it's compulsory for everybody to play. The reason I'm saying compulsory is that quite often, there are a lot of girls who don't want to play. One of the things is that in this day, in India, all the kids have just stopped playing. They're going from one tuition to another. And they've forgotten the joy of having to play. And in this school, as you saw, the beautiful lawns, and I thought, you know, you must play. So they have that. And then they're free again for another half an hour to do whatever they want. And then there's dinner. And after dinner, there's prarthana time, where we say a prarthana and we sing a dhun. And then we reflect on the day's happenings.
Start. How is that? Reflection. Today was a very fantastic day among all the days. Today we meet a freedom fighter named Gosai Bhai Patel, who had told us many things about Dandi March, about Gandhiji and many more.
I feel very interesting with him because he has been in that time. I also feel like we have lost in that time of Gandhiji. I feel little boring when I am reading facts of Gandhiji in book. But when I am listening to this man, I feel very happy and interesting. He told us a poem about
Dandi March. We have also been to Dandi Beach, where Gandhiji ended Dandi March. We had lots of fun there. Thank you.
So, તમે સ્કૂલમાં ઇતિહાસ તો શીખો છો ટેક્સબુકથી અને તમે એક્ઝામ પણ આપો છો અને તમે આવું શીખ્યા છો 10 દિવસ માટે, તો તમને આ બે જે શીખવાની રીત છે એમાં શું ફરક લાગે છે?
એ તો ઘણો ફરક છે, કારણ કે સ્કૂલમાં એટલું બધું જાણવા નહીં મળતું જેટલું અહીંયા આવીને મળે છે. તે ખાલી બુકિશ નોલેજ મળે છે. ડ્રામા કરીએ ત્યારે વધારે જેવું લાગે અને ટેક્સબુક્સથી આપણને તેનું એટલે કે ટેક્સબુકથી આપણને એવું લાગે કે આપણે ખાલી વાંચી ગયા અને મગજમાં ઉતરી ગયા અને પછી પરીક્ષામાં લખ્યા પણ અને આ પણ આખું જીવનમાં ઉતારવા જેવું લાગે.
તમને લાગે છે કે આના પછી તમે આવું કંઈ ભૂલી જશો કે આની આના પાછળની ભાવના ભૂલી જશો?
ના, આ તો નહીં ભૂલી શકાય. ક્યારે નહીં.
એક સ્ટુડન્ટ છે જેના 98% અને હું એની સાથે.
There is a student here who scored 98% in her examinations. I congratulated her and she replied saying, ma'am, there is no cause for congratulations. Only I know what I went through while studying. There was nothing else to my life except for it. I used to study all day and underwent so much pressure that my glucose levels dropped and I had to be hospitalized. So this 98% means nothing to me, and now that I have written it in the examinations, I have forgotten all of it. So despite working so hard, it has brought no change to her life.
Change લાવવાનું જ નથી.
In the school we usually learn with the books and we try to mug up whatever we learn because tests are going to be there. The pressure bees on our head that exams are going to come, tests are going to come. Here we are free. We are not asked the questions from that, that which year it happened, what are the names of it, and we learn practically about the thing, how they feel. We learn that. We don't mug up the dates and the names like that. And in the school we have to mug up and even the pressure is there on the head that exams are going to come. So this is much better than this.
Right. So
stress free learning.
જ્યારે અમે એ સ્ટુડન્ટને ઇન્ટરવ્યુ કરેલો કે વોટ આર ધ બેનિફિટ્સ ઓફ ધીસ સિસ્ટમ ઓવર ધ રેગ્યુલર સિસ્ટમ, એમને સૌથી મહત્વવાળી વાત એ કીધેલી કે ઇટ ઇઝ સ્ટ્રેસ ફ્રી એડ્યુકેશન, કે આઈ થિંક શી મેન્ટ લર્નિંગ ઇઝ અ જોય.
કેમકે આ કેમ્પમાં જ એ છે.
The student studies in this school and has attended the camp and she told me that she now knows how to learn. She plans to study this way and then answer her papers so that learning will not be stressful for her anymore.
તમને લાગે છે કે આ મેથડ ઇટ કેન બી અપ્લાઇડ ઓન અ વાઇડર સ્કેલ?
ઇટ મસ્ટ બી અપ્લાઇડ અને કરવું જોઈએ અને થઈ શકે છે.
થઈ શકે.
ઇટ મસ્ટ બી અપ્લાઇડ એન્ડ ઇટ ઇઝ પોસિબલ ટુ ડુ સો. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, આઈ ટીચ થ્રુ ડ્રામા ઇન માય સ્કૂલ. વન્સ આઈ વેન્ટ ટુ અ સ્મોલ વિલેજ ઇન વલસાડ. આઈ વોઝ ટોલ્ડ બિફોરહેન્ડ ધેટ ધીઝ ચિલ્ડ્રન ડુ નોટ નો હાઉ ટુ રીડ ઓર રાઇટ. દે બેરલી ઇવન અટેન્ડ સ્કૂલ. So how was I going to teach them life skills? When I began teaching, the other teachers were quite skeptical, saying that I was only making them play games. It was very difficult on the first day as the kids were used to the old system, so they knew only how to listen, not think. So on the first day, I only made them play games. In this method, none of the games are pointless. The student learns something even while playing these games. Then when I instructed them to write the names of five feelings for the next day, the teachers did not think that they would be able to do so. But they were stunned the next day when they found that the children, who could barely read or write, had completed the work. So if it can be applied there, it can be applied anywhere.
Do you think your method of teaching can be implemented on a larger scale?
Of course it can. And there are examples and examples of people who have done it abroad in America and in England and in Australia and succeeded. The only trouble is, I think, that you cannot be a lazy teacher if you want to do drama in education.
Because generally it is said that it's very easy to teach very higher class students,
right,
with their notes and this. But when there are no textbook, when there is no syllabus, when there is no prescribed format, teaching the students, it is the most difficult. And this is such area where students, I think, they should be led for exploration.
તમે જ્યારે શીખવાડો તો કેવા ડિફિકલ્ટીઝ ફેસ કરવા પડે આ મેથડ?
First of all, I have to do my homework properly because anyone can ask any questions depending on how they think.
Because if it's just the textbook, then it's just that much that they're going to tell you or ask you. But here, you are letting them reflect. You are letting them think. You are letting them explore. You really never know what they will come up with. There are two answers for this. One is that you have to be more than 100% prepared. So you have to really do your homework before going to teach. The other thing is that the teacher has to be very truthful. For example, if you don't know the answer, you really need to be truthful enough to say that, child, I don't know the answer yet. I will go home and check it and give it to you tomorrow.
Because I think that happens. Because the children are allowed to ask questions.
Exactly. This is what develops their critical thinking and creative thinking. Our normal lessons don't allow that. So through drama, they learn to think for themselves. They learn to solve problems on their own. Like that very nice incident that happened in the interview. When Gandhiji didn't know the answer, his secretary was giving him the answer. You know, that's a beautiful way of learning problem solving. And when things are not in your hand, you need to take decisions there and there on the spot. So the children not only are learning social science, but they're learning decision making, problem solving, critical thinking and creative thinking at the same time.
I was wondering when we got the role into this drama plan, and they told that we will make them learn the dramatic thing. So I was a little bit wondering that what they could be. But then when I saw her, and the way they have understood Gandhi and all that, I think we need to have radical reforms in the way that
the only thing is that now after this you will have an internship. So you may not like that. Because I teach them how to think and how to question and not to take everything that's there in the textbook or told to them for granted. You know? They need to learn to understand. Because they're just learning it by heart, and like I keep telling them that they are taking it in and vomiting it out in the exams, and it's really as gross as that.
Students, they must understand the depth of the content. It is not necessary they should know everything, but whatever they know, it should be acquired well. They should be able to construct, acquire knowledge in a better way.
So here the students go through the whole process that the characters probably went through or something similar. So there is a great, huge amount of empathy. So when your skills of empathy are improved, you become a better learner.
When I teach with a textbook, once I tell them the story, I do not immediately know whether they have understood anything until I take a test. Whereas here they are supposed to make a play immediately after. So if they are confused, they come up and ask me questions. So as a teacher, I can see how much they have understood and clear up their doubts if any arise.
Over and over again in their textbooks, many students don't remember a thing about it.
What is that?
तो आपने भारत की आजादी के विषय क्या सीखा?
थोड़ा सीखा।
क्या क्या सीखा?
कब इंडिपेंडेंस मिली थी, कब रिपब्लिक डे हुआ था
उसको। अच्छा, आपने गांधी जी का तो नाम सुना ही होगा। गांधी जी के विषय आपको क्या पता?
गांधी जी का पुराना
એવું કોને કીધું હતું તમને?
અમારા સરે જ કીધું.
સરે
આપકો દાંડી માર્ચ કે બારે મેં ક્યાં પતા?
દાંડી માર્ચ
Dr. Swaroop Rawal conducts educational camps across the country where she teaches students various subjects through drama. In the summer of 2012, she began her 10-day camp at the LP Savani Academy in Surat to teach 40 students from the ages of 8 to 14 the Dandi March and civil disobedience through drama and take Gandhiji out of the textbook.
What exactly is teaching through drama?
Teaching through drama is very simple. It's about using drama to bring about a change in understanding. Drama in education is about the teacher and the student. It is not about making a play, but the process of making a play. The change of understanding or learning happens in the process. Of course, there would be a play all through, but the learning is in the process and not the final product. There are different methods used in it. One of them is theater games. Then there is tableaus, improvisations. The whole class works in one single play. And it may be 20 people, 30 people. And the whole play may go on for 3, 4, 5 consecutive lessons. So it just depends on the teacher, how she wants to use it.
Everything is done through drama. So they've been doing drama and it's not, because I don't believe in making actors, it's not about making actors. This is called drama in education, so it is how drama is used to teach.
On the 12th of March 1930, Mahatma Gandhi marched to Dandi to break the unjust tax on salt applied by the British Empire. This legendary march was a cornerstone in the history of our nation. Yet today, despite having studied it...
और आपने गांधी जी और हमारे इंडिपेंडेंस मूवमेंट का आपने कौन से स्टैंडर्ड से पढ़ना चालू किया?
मेरे हिसाब से मैंने थर्ड फोर्थ में किया।
थर्ड फोर्थ से आपने चालू किया पढ़ना इंडियन मूवमेंट के बारे में। अच्छा, थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू।
हाउ इज टीचिंग थ्रू ड्रामा डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द रेगुलर वे ऑफ टीचिंग?
द मेन डिफरेंस इज दैट इट्स एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग। यू एक्सपीरियंस एवरीथिंग द कैरेक्टर्स द पीपल the things experienced at the time when it happened to them, instead of just opening a textbook and listening and reading words.
Generally what happens today, if you find 90% A, 95% A++, grade A grade, and thought computation, what we say, like they learn, but at times we find that the learning is a bit hollow because of surface level.
Yes.
Textbook learning can